All right, welcome to Conservative Counterculture Radio, the voice of Operation 139. This is Val Valano coming to you live from Eugene, Oregon. We have a very exciting show tonight lined up for you. We have a military soldier who is coming on. I'm going to address her as entimes for disclosure reasons. First, real quick, I want to give a shout-out to those listening abroad. We had some hits today from different countries. We've got Korea. We've got Estonia, Japan, Slovenia, United Kingdom, of course, our friends in Canada. And we love when we start really reaching out there, and it seems like we are able to do that more and more. And welcome everybody that is pouring into the chat room. We are going to be talking about all kinds of stuff, and with no further ado, please welcome our guest in time. How are you doing this evening?
I'm doing great, Val. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. I know you've got all kinds of stuff to talk about. I am going to go ahead and let you open with where you want to start, and let's just take it away.
Okay. Thank you, Val. I think it was like the 12th or 13th of September last month. And let me give you a little bit of background about me first. I'm an E7 in the military, National Guard, full-time, not the one weekend a month, 2 weeks a year person. I do this full-time. I went to drill last month here in California, and during that weekend drill, another E7 approached me and told me that they were just handed out these things called Pioneer 1.5. Just to give your listeners an idea of what Pioneer 1.5 is, they are tracking devices, or let me put it like this, they're beacons to differentiate who is friendly and who's not. So we usually get those when we deploy to Iraq or Afghanistan, and we usually get those in Kuwait just before we hop another jump over to Iraq or Afghanistan. However, here in the state of California, every single person that's in the military, National Guard wise, is being handed these Pioneer 1.5 to identify us as friendlies. After he told me that, he said he approached a couple LAPD and a couple CHP officers because we had previously viewed the video. The video with the other, I think he's a retired CHP officer who had told us on video with Catherine Albright there, or Madeline Albright, that they had we were going to get these shots. They were going to be forced upon us. Once they were forced upon us, we were to put bracelets on our arm. And they weren't the kind of bracelets that can be removed. They were meant to be permanent. And once they were put in permanent, they are also they have these things called a biochip in there that monitors your system to see if you get sick. Also, RFID chip, radio frequency identification, which tells them where you are at all times. And the way he put it was they were going to set up checkpoints throughout the country and check people at the checkpoint to see if you had had your shots or not. And if you had not had your shots, you'd have an opportunity there to take your shot. And if you didn't take your shot, they would load you on a bus and take you to a camp. And that's what we had previously viewed. So he said he worked with these guys, so he went to work. And once he went to work that weekend, he approached a couple of LAPD officers and some CHP officers, and they told him that because of the type of job that we have, it's kind of sensitive, and they just assumed that we all knew, you know, what they were doing. He told him right out, yes, we've been running a lot of different drills. We've been running roadblocks, how to quarantine people, and whatnot. So he found that quite interesting in the fact that they were also handing out new issue that included the Pioneer 1.5, which we don't really need here in the state in this country unless they're going to declare martial law. Then they would have to identify us as friendly. Also,
so basically, you know, like you said earlier, the whole friendly triage, whatever you want to call that, is for when you're in foreign land, but this is for our home territory.
This is for our home territory, but they're not telling the soldiers that, Val. They're telling the soldiers, this is just part of your new issue. That's all it is. It's part of your new issue, and it's packed away until we're told to use it.
Mm-hmm. Very curious, very curious. Well, why don't you go ahead and give a little bit of for those that don't know, that might say, oh, you shouldn't be talking to people. Why is it that you're wanting to tell people, I know you're a Christian, what is laying on your heart to get this information out, and why?
What's laying on my heart is I hope there's a lot of military listening to my voice right now. Because, see, I've been bombarded with some really cruel, hateful things on my channel in regards to that one video I made out that got over 250,000 views just on my channel alone. You don't have to follow an illegal order. You don't have to follow something that's unconstitutional. The moment we start policing our own state, our own people, that in itself is wrong. And you have the right as a private to say no to that. And that's what's laying on my heart right now. I'm afraid that there's going to be a lot of military members that just don't want to mess up. Let me put it like this. I am I'm 2 years away from retirement. I really don't want to say no or do anything to rock the boat so that I don't get my retirement. Or, mm-hmm. I've been doing really good in my unit, and I really don't want to do anything to go against this guy because I'm afraid of reprisal. I'm afraid he's going to come back and do something to me later. This is the moment. Mm-hmm. This is the time to stand up. And it's not just the American people, and it's not a violent stand-up. It's just to stand up and say, no, we're not going to tolerate this. No, we're not going to do it. And I've been approached by people that say, you can't be in the military. Going to a Salvation Army and buying a uniform doesn't make you a soldier. Well, I have 16, almost 17 years in the service, and all of it except for 1 year has been active duty. Being a soldier, you make an oath when you come in. You put your hand up and you swear to God to uphold and defend the Constitution against enemies both foreign and domestic. Now, I don't know about the rest of the guys, the rest of the soldiers, but I take that oath very seriously. This is my country. I love it. I went to Iraq. I served for a year in hopes that whatever was happening over there would not come to my country. And I'm sure there are a lot of soldiers out there that agree with what I'm saying. Yes, I put that video out. Yes, I think that they know about me. I did receive an email from a lady whose brother works at the White House, who said that it's been viewed at the White House and been dismissed, and they were all told that it wasn't true. So I know that message is out there. Alex Jones contacted me, or he had someone contact me and wanted me to go on, said it would be safer for me if I put myself more out in the public. Well,
exactly.
I have to disagree with him. Putting myself out there in the public like that, it only creates another – I'd be a martyr, and I don't want to martyr myself right now. Mm-hmm. I mean, I may have to one of these days, right? I mean, if they tell me to denounce my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I'm not going to do that. And if they want to take my life, they can take my life then. But as far as putting myself out there where they can see what unit I'm in, see where I'm at, they already know that, Val. They already know. They know everything there is to know about what's going on right now and who is talking. And I know this because a week after I put that video out, I was given orders to Afghanistan. I was given orders to Afghanistan, not with my present company, but a whole different company.
What better way to shut you up than to get you out of the country?
Exactly. That's what I was thinking. But it could be coincidence. You never know. I don't want to jump to too many conclusions.
Mm-hmm. But it's
kind of odd.
We don't want to jump to conclusions, and it's so easy to. We've all done it. I've made the mistakes in past. Everybody that I know have made the mistakes in past because we are living in scary times, and we are to be watchful. And, you know, it's better to be safe than sorry. And to me, being safe is looking at all possibilities with a reserved attitude. Let's put it that way. So looking at all possibilities with a reserved attitude, so that way you're prepared at all costs.
Exactly. I just recently put a video out about that, too, about being prepared. It doesn't matter if it's this type of...